Hi all, welcome to OET speaking class. Today we can discuss an OET role play. Here the setting is a GP practice. You are a nurse at GP practice. A patient has come with problems during sleep. His condition is noted as sleep apnea. The doctor at the clinic has sent him to you for further instructions, which you will discuss with the patient now. Task: inquire about his problem and reassure him. Explain about sleep apnea and its management, CPAP mask, lifestyle changes. Advise him to make changes in diet and drinking habits. Here, the setting is a GP practice, so we can start our conversation by saying, good morning, then the patient might greet you. Then we can say, my name is Sarah, I am one of the registered nurses working in this GP practice. Then we can ask, how may I address you? Here the name is Mr. John. And the patient has been referred for further instructions. So we can ask like this, I understand that you have been referred by your doctor for some instructions. Is that right? Then the patient might tell you, yes sister, you are right. I'm really confused about my condition. I don't know about my condition, what to do now. In that situation, we need to inquire about the cause of his worries. We can ask like, Mr. John, I seen from your notes that you have some problems during sleep. Could you please explain more about that? Then, as per the interlocutor's card, he may tell you like, sister, 6 months back, I got a car accident. Since then, I have some problems like snoring. And my doctor told me it's something like sleep apnea. Actually, I don't know much about that. At that time, we need to reassure the patient. We can say like this, all right, Mr. John, I do really understand that this must be difficult for you. Try not to be worried. We are here to help you. You know, Mr. John, your condition can be managed with the treatment and some lifestyle changes. Then, as per our task, we can explain about what is sleep apnea and its management. We can say like this, sleep apnea is a condition that causes breathing to stop and start during sleep. I am sorry to say that it's a serious problem if you don't manage your condition. Is that clear? Probably the patient may ask you questions like, sister, is it related to snoring? Then we can reply like, no, Mr. John. Snoring is different from sleep apnea. Sleep apnea is caused by the throat closing short time during our sleeping. This closes the upper airway so breathing stops. After a short time, the brain realizes that breathing stops and triggers breathing again. In your case, this is the situation. Are you following me? Then probably he may ask you, sister, is it really serious? Then we can say like, Mr. John, I realize that this comes as a shock to you. I assure you that we can effectively treat this condition. You don't worry about that. Then we can explain about the management of sleep apnea. Sometimes the patient may ask you, sister, is there any medicine for this condition? I'm really concerned about my condition. At that time, we can explain about the management of sleep apnea. We can say like this, all right, Mr. John, I understand that you are really anxious. If I were you, I would react the same. I will explain about the management of this problem. This is a device with special mask that you can use at night. Also, please make some changes in your lifestyle, which will be very effective. Is that clear? Then probably the patient may tell you like, yeah, yes, sister, the doctor has mentioned something like that. Okay, then we can say, yes, of course, you are right, Mr. John. It's called CPAP mask. CPAP means continuous positive airway pressure. The mask looks a bit like an oxygen mask, but it works in a different way. It helps to increase the pressure in your throat so that your airways do not collapse, cause you to stop breathing. Is that clear? Then sometimes patient may ask you a question like, sister, how do I use it? Then we can tell him like, Mr. John, you put the mask on the same way as an oxygen mask. You need to use at night to get a good sleep. Is that clear? After that, as per our task, we can ask questions about the patient's lifestyle. We can ask like, could you please tell me about your habits? Could you please tell me about your diet pattern? Have you noticed any changes in your weight? These questions you can ask one by one. Then probably the patient may reply like, sister, I'm drinking alcohol and I prefer outside food, not doing any exercise. In that situation, we need to give advice. You can advise him to make some changes in your diet and drinking habits. We can say like, now I'm going to give you some instructions regarding your drinking habit. Is that okay? Firstly, I recommend you to avoid drinking alcohol. Is that okay? Sometimes the patient may agree with you. If he doesn't agree with you, then we can say like, Mr. John, I know it's difficult to stop all of a sudden, but you can limit your taste. Mr. John, I know it's difficult to stop all of a sudden, but you can limit your daily intake of alcohol to a small amount. So gradually you can make some changes. That will be very helpful for you. Are you following me? Another thing is, make some changes in your lifestyle. You know, Mr. John, it's really important that you need to maintain a healthy weight. Excess weight, particularly in the neck area, also plays a big part in your ability to breathe well when you are lying down. So it's really important to take off as much as pressure in your throat area. Is that clear? Probably the patient may ask you, sister, how can I reduce my weight? Then we can tell him like, Mr. John, I'm glad to hear that you are agreed with my suggestion. Regarding the diet, I can give you a leaflet. Please go through that, which contains information regarding weight loss and the nutritious diet plan that you can follow. Is that okay? Then you can ask, do you have any other concerns? Sometimes the patient may ask like, sister, if I don't take this treatment, what will happen? What will be happen in the future? That situation, we can tell him like, Mr. John, I understand your perspectives. The important thing to remember about your condition is that it's not simply a form of snoring. If it's not managed properly, it can be a serious condition. You know, Mr. John, people with sleep apnea have increased risk of high blood pressure and heart attack. Let me assure you that if you follow our instructions, you can effectively manage your condition so that you can lead a normal life. Is that clear? Then we can ask, okay, Mr. John, do you have any other concerns? If the patient has no other concerns, then we can wind up our conversation by saying, I hope I have cleared all your concerns. If you need any more help, please call me at any time. I'm happy to help you. This is my number. Then you can give your number. Okay, Mr. John, get well soon.